Hello, my name is Grace. Today I'm going to tell you about my first emotions and my opinion. The building and start of this river was originally built in 1892 as part of the Neptune Metal Factory. After the factory shut down, the building remained empty for many years. In the 1970s, it was purchased by property developer Jerry Rocco. He had no plans for it at the time. So when he was approached by a local graffiti artist in 1990s, he agreed to let the family paint graffiti on the walls of the building. In 1993, the building became home to the Fun Factory and its graffiti terminators program. It improved the public image of graffiti. Some locals started to see graffiti as a beautiful new type of art. Suddenly, Mr. Rogoff announced plans to rebuild Five Point buildings as new apartment buildings. Mr. Rogoff ignored the protest of residents and other art lovers worldwide. He claimed that he was free to do whatever he wanted with his property. Without warning, Mr. Rogoff had painted over the artwork in the middle of the night. Some of the artists got together and came up with a plan. In April 2017, 21 artists from Five Points filed a lawsuit against Jerry Rogoff over the destruction of their artwork. The judge finally agreed with the artist. He awarded the maximum amount of the money possible under the law, $115,000 per piece of artwork, for a total of over $6.7 million in damages. I think the outcome of this lawsuit is right, because he ignored Five Points and artist's opinions, and he painted the artworks without any worry. This is all about my presentation. Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Kana Kim. I'm going to tell you what happened to Five Points building. Let's start my presentation. What is Five Points? Five Points was an architecture located in Queens, Long Island City. There were workrooms for artists inside the building. It was like this, but as you know, it became like this. I'm going to tell you the story of this building. Five Points building was an abandoned factory of Neptune meters, but in 1970, a developer named Jerry Rocco bought this building. At first, he had no plans for the building, so there were a lot of graffiti artists flocking to the building, and Mr. Jerry Rocco allowed them to do graffiti on the wall of the building. One day of 2013, Mr. Jerry Rocco planned to demolish Five Points building and build a new one. Residents, art lovers, and graffiti artists strongly protested, but Jerry Rocco ignored it. On November 19, 2013, graffiti artists were shocked and greeted in the morning. Because their works of art were painted with white paint. Without a word warning, Mr. Jerry Rocco painted all of those works of art over the night. The artists were angry at his behavior soon, and surprisingly, the result of the lawsuit was that Mr. Jerry Rocco had to provide $6.7 million to 21 artists. Actually, I disagree with the judgment, because I think the building was his own property, so he can do whatever he wants to on his building. Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Grant Kim. Have you ever heard of graffiti? Graffiti is the act of drawing or writing on public places or walls with spray painting. Five Points that I will introduce today is a story about graffiti. Five Points was originally a part of Neptune Meter Factory. After the factory was shut down, developer Jerry Rocco purchased it. At that time, he didn't have any plans for it. So when local artists approached him, he allowed them to paint freely on the walls. Then in 2002, Jonathan Cohen, a local graffiti artist, renamed the building Five Points and planned to make graffiti museum there. Under his direction, Five Points became internationally famous and attracted many artists and tourists from all over the world. In 2013, Jerry Wolkoff announced the plans to rebuild Five Points as new apartment buildings. He ignored the protests of many people, and the city approved his plan. Then on the morning of November 19, 2013, the Five Points artists awoke to something shocking, because all of their mirrors were gone. Without any warning, Mr. Roku painted over the artwork in the middle of the night. There was nothing the artists could do. The new apartment project continued, and by the end of 2014, the Five Points building was destroyed completely. In April 2017, 21 artists from Five Points filed a lawsuit against Jerry Wolkoff. The artists claimed that Mr. Wolkoff had violated the Visual Artists' Rights Act, which protects artists and their artwork. On the other hand, Mr. Wolkoff's lawyers argued that the graffiti at Five Points was always meant to be temporary. The judge agreed with the artist. He felt that the graffiti at Five Points was world famous, and the artwork deserved the same protections under the law. So he awarded over $6.7 million. This court case is the first that changed the relationship with graffiti and the law. Artists have many rights, and their artwork is protected under the law. This is big win for graffiti artists. However, is this trial really fair? Some people agree the judgment. They think that he damaged world famous works of value, so he deserves the punishment. And they say the missing works cannot be returned. On the other hand, other people disagree the judgment. They say that graffiti is originally illegal and he can use it freely as the building belongs to him. Also, they think that the punishment is too much. How do you think about this trial? Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Sonia. Do you know anything about Five Points? I will introduce about Five Points today. First, about Five Points. Second, what happened in Five Points. Third, my opinion. About Five Points, Wolkoff bought a building, but he didn't have any plan. So he left the building. Later, many artists painted gravy on the building and it called Five Points. What happened in Five Points? Wolkoff gave artists low rent studios and allowed them to paint gravy on the building. One day, Wolkoff said them get out because government announced plan to rebuild Five Points. But they didn't because of their artworks. When artists fled, Wolkoff painted their artwork, like this picture. So artist claimed him. The judge said Wolkoff must pay $6.7 million to artists. This was the first time that Gregory became an artwork. My opinion. I think the outcome was right. Although the building was Wolkoff's, He didn't do any warning. He acted too emotionally. Plus, bravery is one of the famous arts. Anything can't bring their artwork. Thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Carmen. Today I'm going to tell you about my points, lawsuit, and my opinion. The building at the heart of this trio was originally built in 1892 as part of the Neptune Metal Factory. After the factory shut down, the building remained empty for many years. In the 1970s, it was purchased by property developer Jerry Wilco. He had no plans for it at the time. So when he was approached by local graffiti artists in the 1990s, he agreed to let them freely paint graffiti on the walls of the building. In 1993, the building became home to the Film Factory and its Graffiti Terminators program. It improved the public image of graffiti. Some locals started to see graffiti as a beautiful, new type of art. Suddenly, Mr. Wilcox announced plans to rebuild Five Points building as new apartment buildings. Mr. Wilcox ignored the protest of residents and other art lovers worldwide. He claimed that he was free to do whatever he wanted with his property. Without warning, Mr. Wilcox had painted over the artwork in the middle of the night. Some of the artists got together and came up with a plan. In April 2017, 21 artists from Five Points filed a lawsuit against Jerry Wilcox over the destruction of their artwork. The judge finally agreed with the artist. He awarded the maximum amount of money possible under the law. $150,000 per piece of artwork. For a total over $6.7 million in damages. I think it is right to that the artists are paid because Mr. Wilcox destroyed their artwork without consent, and Mr. Wilcox agreed from the beginning that he was free to do graffiti. Thank you for listening. Bye.